Please stand.
Mercy on us and give us our sins.
Let us pray.
Shall
Lo mismo hizo con el cáliz después de cenar, diciendo: Este cáliz es la nueva alianza que se sella con mi sangre. Hagan esto en memoria mía siempre en delante de él. Por eso, cada vez que ustedes comen de este pan y beben de este cáliz, proclaman la muerte del Señor hasta que vuelva. Palabra de Dios.
Before the feast of the Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to pass from this world into the Father. He loved his own in the world, and he loved them to the end. The devil had already induced Judas, son of Simon the Iscariot, to hand him over. So during supper, fully aware that the Father had put everything into his power, and that he had come from God and was returning to God, he rose from supper, took off his outer garments. He took a towel and tied it around his waist. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash his disciples' feet and dry them with a towel around his waist. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Master, are you going to wash my feet?" And Jesus answered and said to him, "What I am doing, you do not understand now, but you will understand later." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered him, "Unless I wash you, you will have no inheritance in me." Simon Peter said to him, "Master, then not only my feet, but my hands and my head as well." Jesus said to him, "Whoever has bathed has no need except to have his feet washed, for he is clean all over. So you are clean, but not all." For he knew who would betray him. For this reason, he said, "Not all of you are clean." So when he washed their feet and put his garment back on, and reclined at table again, he said to them, "Do you realize what I have done for you? You call me teacher and master, and rightly so, for indeed I am. If I, therefore, the master and the teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash one another's feet. I have given you a model to follow, so that as I have done for you, you should also do." The Gospel of the Lord.
as we come to the celebration of Holy Thursday and the beginning of the sacred triduum, I am always struck by this night, which is about the institution of the Eucharist. It is about serving. It is about what it means to be a servant leader. It's about betrayal. It's about a meal. And as we come here tonight, we come, I think, at a time where we begin to celebrate, see some light at the end of the tunnel of what we've been going through as a people. I think as we hear the gospel tonight, what we experience in Jesus Christ is, first of all, the call to charity, to love one another. First of all, in the meal that he shares with his brothers and whoever else was there. The charity and love of a meal, hospitality, of being in union with one another. But then Jesus shows them ultimately what it means. If you love, you will serve. You will wash the feet. I must wash your feet, and you must wash the feet of one another. You must serve. And therein, I think, lies the interesting thing about this night. That balance that we have to live in between prayer and action. Prayer and action. The Eucharist that we celebrate is about prayer. The food that we eat is Jesus Christ. But it calls us to action. You hear me say it all the time. You can't come to church and receive the Eucharist and leave the same. The Eucharist causes us to become that which we receive, and in receiving Christ and in becoming Christ, we must go forth and be Christ to one another. Because we are brothers and sisters. That was brought home to me at the priest meeting the other day on Tuesday, when Bishop Knight was talking about the young boys who are at Freeman Auditorium. Young boys who have traveled thousands of miles. We can hardly fathom any of our children, 5 years old, 7 years old, 9 years old, walking downtown, much less across several countries, to get to the United States. And Bishop Knight said, they're young boys. They're not gang members. They are young boys. And he said, in talking to them, what he found out was this, that almost all of them were baptized in the Catholic Church. He says, they are our children. That's how we have to see one another. We are baptized. We are brothers and sisters in Christ. They are our children. They're not people escaping Honduras and Guatemala and the other places where they are coming from. They're our brothers and sisters. We have an obligation to take care of our brothers and sisters. What we do here, brothers and sisters, at this place, at this time, we remember what took place at the Last Supper. We celebrate and we receive Christ who is present yet again. But as always, it calls us to action. To action. To bring about change and service and love and charity in the world. This night, model Jesus Christ in terms of being a servant. How many of the people in their places of business, in the place where we go, model this for us? But Jesus Christ always turns everything upside down. What we would normally think of a leader, Jesus says, you want to be a leader? Then serve. And if you serve, do so out of love. It's about prayer, but it's about action. Let us put our love of one another and our love for Jesus Christ.
supper died, the Lord Jesus washed the feet of his disciples and commanded them to do the same. Remembering the Lord's selfless love for us, we serve him with our prayers.
For the church, that we may live like Jesus and spend our lives in loving service, washing the feet, carrying the burdens, and confronting the brokenness of one another, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the grace of unity, that divisions may be healed, unity restored, that we may support one another and bring forth the reign of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are suffering, that God will help the hungry find food, the persecuted relief, the abandoned inclusion and acceptance, and the unemployed new opportunities to use their gifts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are burdened by separation from others because of the virus, that we may have God's presence with them and have their strength and patience renewed, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and those approaching death, particularly those with the coronavirus 19, that God will ease their suffering and send an angel to comfort and to strengthen them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those soon to be nourished with the Lord's body on their journey into eternal life, that the dying may offer their lives to God as a sacrifice of thanksgiving, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
I want to pray for our three parishes, that as communities and as a community, we may continue to grow in our love for one another, in our service for one another, as we continue to build the body of Christ here on the east side of San Antonio. We pray to the Lord.
Lord
God, your Son Jesus Christ demonstrates for us the way of perfect humility. Give us the strength to be like him in all that we do, washing the feet of both friend and foe. May these sacred days draw us into the mystery of his suffering and death and resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Where there's sadness, there's joy. Oh,
Grace to the brothers that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and all of us, Holy Church.
Concedemos, Señor, participar dignamente en estos misterios, porque cada vez que se celebra el memorial de este sacrificio, se realiza la obra de nuestra redención por Jesucristo nuestro Señor.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for Christ our Lord. For he is the true and eternal priest, who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice, and was the first to offer himself as a saving victim, commanding us to make this offering in his memorial, as we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong, and as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing to him in your glory, as without end we acclaim. Remember, Lord, your servants. And all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, for they offer it for themselves and for all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls and hope of health and well-being, and paying our homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day, on which our Lord Jesus Christ is handed over for our sake, and in communion with the whole, with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, his spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysostomus, John, and Paul, Cosmas, and David, and all of your saints. We ask you for their merits and prayers in all things that we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family which we make to you, as we observe the day on which our Lord Jesus Christ handed on the mysteries of his body and blood, for his disciples to celebrate. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation encountered among the flock of those who have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect, so that it's spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become from us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was suffered for our salvation and the salvation of all, that is today, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his Almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands. And once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. In humble prayer, we ask, Almighty God, command these gifts to be borne by the hand of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation of the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember us, O Lord, in the servants of Francis Alco, Gustavo Al Bishop. We have gone before us with the sign of faith and rested in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, to all who sleep in Christ, a place of our refreshment, light, and peace. To you also, the servants who those sinners, hope in your abundant merit, mercies, graciously grant us some share. And fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John about this, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all the saints, admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not wishing our merits, but granting us your power. Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, for every evil, gracious, and grant peace in our days. by the help of your mercy. Libranos de todos los males, Señor, y concédenos la paz de nuestros días, para que hayamos por tu misericordia, vivamos siempre libres de pecado, porque vivimos en tu perturbación, mientras esperamos por nuestra vida de nuestro Salvador Jesucristo. Señor Jesucristo, bendice tus apóstoles, la paz, la fe, y paz, la gloria. No tengas en cuenta de nuestros pecados, sino la fe de tu iglesia. Y conforme a tu palabra, concede la paz y la unidad que viviremos por los siglos de los siglos.
Amén.
Paz del Señor esté siempre con ustedes. unite ourselves with our brothers and sisters who are watching live stream. My Jesus, I believe in your present and blessed sacrament. I love you above all things and I desire you with all my heart. Since I cannot believe in you set our end to me, I ask you to come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already in my heart and unite myself to you completely. Please do not let me ever be separated from you. Amen. Before the communion prayer, just an announcement that Stations of the Cross will begin at 2 o'clock tomorrow afternoon at St. Michael's, and the liturgy for Good Friday will be at 3 o'clock. On Holy Saturday at 8:15, Mass is on Easter Sunday, 8, St. Michael's, 9, Holy Redeemer, 10:30, Our Lady of Perpetual Help. Today, as I was preparing the church and the other churches for the ceremonies, I'm really blessed to have three parishes that I have, diverse as they are, you know, they really are an interesting really to be wonderful parishes. And I'm very blessed to be a priest of Jesus Christ that gets to serve at least three parishes. So I hope that we can continue to build up the body of Christ with one another. There's lots of work to do. Tonight there are baskets at the doors of the church. Normally what we do is we use the money to using our food giveaways that we have. My suggestion is that tonight, of any money that is collected, we give to Catholic Charities for the support of the immigrants who are in Freeman Auditorium to help them. The things that they might need, there's all kinds of things that they need as young boys. And so anything that we collect, we will to support them at Freeman Auditorium, the young men. And also, there will be a basket of bread at each door. Please take a look as you leave. Take some time to pray after I do. Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that justice may are renewed by the supper of your Son in this present age, so we may enjoy his banquet for all eternity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
God sees.